Now we are in our 11th unit, Integral Calculus. While simply telling, integration is the reverse process or converse of differentiation. And integration is also called as antiderivative. Okay, so while differentiating f of x, it will become f dash of x. While integrating f dash of x, you get f of x again. This is integration. Okay, so integration, we call integration as antiderivative. Okay, derivative or reverse process, that is antiderivative. So integration f dash of x, antiderivative of f dash of x gives you f of x. Remember, while differentiating f of x, you get f dash of x. இல்லை அப்போன எக்ஸசைஸ் ஃபுல்லாக தான். f of x differentiate பண்ணும்போது you will get the first order derivative, that is f dash of x. Okay, so இப்போ integrate பண்ணும்போது f dash of x integrate பண்ணும்போது again you get f of x. Now let's see few basic rules of integration. Here in this column you can see the derivatives. Here the integration, that means the antiderivatives. Okay, so integration is the reverse process. Okay, you have to keep it in mind always while learning the integration. So differentiation of a constant function is zero, like differentiate panumbodhu. But here while differentiating nothing, while differentiating zero, you get some constant. Okay, so differentiation of kx differentiate panna x ku power 1, so we will ignore it, isn't it? So you get k. First ஒரு இதாக இருக்குது, பவர் ஒன் தான் இருக்குதுன்னா வில் ரைட் இட் அஸ் கே. ஹியர் வெல் டிஃப்ரென்ஷியேட்டிங் கே டி எக்ஸ், யூ கெட் கே எக்ஸ். ஓகே, ஆப்போசிட்டாக வரும். ஸோ டிஃப்ரென்சியேஷன் ஆஃப் எக்ஸ் பார் என், டிஃப்ரென்சியேஷன் ஆஃப் எக்ஸ் பார் என் கிவ்ஸ் யூ, தட் இஸ் தி டிஃப்ரென்சியேஷன் ஆஃப் எக்ஸ் பார் என் கிவ்ஸ் யூ n into x power n minus 1. இது தான் நம்ம படித்தோம் இல்லையா. ஹியர் டிஃப்ரென்சியேஷன் ஆஃப் x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. இதை டிஃப்ரென்ஷியேட் பண்ணால் என்னாகும், x power n plus 1 the numerator, while differentiating this you get n plus 1 into x power n plus 1 minus 1 இல்லையா, பவர் மைனஸ் 1 பண்ணுவோம். அதே மாதிரி இந்த டினாமினேட்டர் ஆல்சோ ஆல்ரெடி வி ஹாவ் n plus 1. So in the n plus 1 will get cancel. Here plus 1 minus 1 will get cancel and you get x power n. So integration of x power n plus 1 dx gives you x power n plus 1 by n plus 1. But yeah, so இதுக்கு opposite. In the value differentiate பண்ணும்போது நமக்கு x power n கிடைக்குது. So in the value, அதே value நம்ம integrate பண்ணும்போது நமக்கு இந்த expression அப்படியே கிடைக்குது. Okay. So log x oda differentiation 1 by x, inga 1 by x oda integration you get log x. Similarly cos x ku, okay, differentiation of cos x vandu minus sin x illaya, cos x oda differentiation minus sin x, so minus cos x ku sin x kedaikum. So integration sin x gives you minus cos x. Adhe madri dhaan sin x cos x. Okay, so tan x oda differentiation secant square x, so secant square x integrate panna namakku enna kedaikum, tan x. Okay, similarly for the other trigonometric ratios, cot x minus cot x ku minus cot x gives you cosecant square x, so cosecant square x oda integration minus cot x, secant x க்கு secant x tan x, that is differentiation. So integration க்கு அதுக்கு opposite, so minus cosecant x. அதே மாதிரி தான் e power x க்கு என்ன, differentiation of e power x is e power x. So here also e power x oda integration gives you e power x plus c. Differentiation of a power x by log a gives you a power x. So a power x க்கு differentiate, sorry, integrate பண்ணும்போது a power x divided by log a. So these are the important formula. Sin inverse x க்கு என்ன, tan inverse x க்கு என்ன. Okay, So integration of 1 minus 1 divided by square root of 1 minus x square gives you sin inverse x. Therefore, integration of 1 by 1 plus x square dx gives you tan inverse x. These are the few basic rules, and we have to do few problems using these rules. In exercise 11.1, we are going to integrate the following functions with respect to the variable x. As we know, integration is the reverse process or the converse of differentiation. Integration la enna varudho differentiation la pandradhukku opposite la nama pandra maadhiri irukum. Okay, so x power 11, the first problem. So integration, integral x power 11 dx. This is integration. We are integrating this function with respect to x. We know integral x power n dx is equal to x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus c. Okay, here n is 11, so that is equal to x power 11 plus 1 divided by 11 plus 1 plus c. It's a constant, some constant. So x power 12 divided by 12 plus c is the integration. Similarly, the second subdivision, 1 by x power 7. We can write it as x power minus 7. Okay, so integral x power minus 7 dx. We can use the same formula, that is equal to x power minus 7 plus 1 divided by minus 7 plus 1 plus c, x power n plus 1 divided by n plus 1. What is x power minus 7 plus 1? That is x power minus 7 plus 1, that is minus 6 divided by minus 6 plus the constant c. Next, third one, cube root of x power 4. We can write it as x power 4 the whole power 1 by 3. Cube root, we can write it as 1 by 3. That is equal to x power 4 by 3. Now, we can differentiate this or integrate this. So, integral x power 4 by 3 dx is equal to x power 4 by 3 plus 1 divided by 4 by 3 plus 1 plus the constant c. That is equal to x power, we can take 3 as LCM, so 4 by 3 plus 1, so 4 plus 3 divided by 3, so 7 by 3, here also 7 by 3 plus c, that is equal to, we can write this as the reciprocal, that is 3 into x power 7 by 3 divided by 7 plus c is the answer. Fourth one, x power 5 the whole power 1 by 8 into dx. We can do it similarly, that is we can write this as x power 5 by 8 dx. So you can do it by yourself. In the second subdivision, first problem is 1 by sine square x. Okay, so 1 by sine, 1 by sine is cosecant, that is equal to cosecant square x dx. So integral cosecant square x dx. What is integration of cosecant square x? Cosecant square x is equal to minus cot x plus constant c. So 1 by sine square x, integration of 1 by sine square x is equal to minus cot x plus c. This trigonometrical ratios we have to do like this. Second one is tan x by cos x. So tan x by cos x, I can write it as tan x into 1 by cos. 1 by cos is secant. Secant x. So tan x into secant x. So integral tan x secant x is dx is equal to tan x secant x oda differentiation edoda differentiation secant x oda differentiation da secant x tan x. So integration of secant x tan x is equal to secant x plus the constant c. Third one, cos x divided by sin square x, we have to integrate this. So 1 by sin square, 1 by sin square is secant square x, but now I am going to write this as cos x by sin x into sin x. Okay, so cos by sin, that will become cot x, 1 by sin, that become cosecant x. So integral of cos x by sin square x dx, that is equal to integral cot x cosecant x dx. Cot x cosecant x is the differentiation of cosecant x, illaya cosecant x differentiate pannumbodhu you get minus cot x cosecant x. So while integrating cot x cosecant x, here we get minus cosecant x plus c. Okay, so cot x cosecant x differentiate pannumbodhu integrate pannumbodhu namakku minus cosecant x kedaikudhu, ena cosecant x oda differentiation minus cot x into cosecant x. So inga minus inga irukra minus andha pakkam poidu, that's the difference. First subdivision in third problem, 12 cube. 12 cube is a constant, there is no variable here. So integral 12 cube dx is equal to 12 cube x plus c. For a constant, integration of constant. Second subdivision, x power 24 divided by x power 25. While simplifying this, you get 1 by x. Illaya inga x power 24 irukku, inga x power 25. So simplify pannona 25 times poidum, only 24 times poidum, ori x mattum remain aagum. Okay, so 1 by x. Now while integrating this, x power 24 by x power 25 dx is equal to integral 1 by x dx. Okay, so 1 by x edoda differentiation, log x oda differentiation da 1 by x. Appo 1 by x integrate pannumbodhu namakku enna kedaikum, log x, that is log mod x plus c. Okay, similarly third, e power x dx, e power x dx அப்படினு சொன்னா, while integrating that e power x, அது வந்து எதோட integration, differentiation of e power x is e power x, e power x differentiate பண்ணா நமக்கு e power x தான் கிடைக்கும். So while integrating also, integration of e power x is always equal to e power x plus some constant